my friends, and yes, I will be finally doing another Star Wars theme kit with the Death Star 2 and Star Destroyer, with, you know, the Death Star being in 1 to 2,700,000 scale, which is, I'd say, probably the largest but smallest scale slash model I've ever done, and also the 1 to 14,500 scale size Star Destroyer. And as you can see, it is flourished with nicely well done details by Bandai, as well as on the smooth surfaces that you can obviously see there. It came with nice little stickers that you see me place on at the end onto the painted black clear parts, as well as it with it coming with a very nice informative construction kit, as well as the painting marking guide. Now we can begin cutting off the parts from the sprues with just my cheap little sharp side sprue cutters, just to make sure that it cuts off nice and clean. Luckily, you don't need any liquid cement or just glue for gluing together the parts on this snap fit together model, but it's entirely up to you. But having the liquid cement also helps for filling up those large gaps that you will see later on. I should also mention that this is actually not a model for me, but a gift or birthday gift for my older brother. So yeah, I'd say since we both enjoy and love Star Wars, this is a pretty good gift. Now with the Death Star 2 done, we can finally start building the Star Destroyer, as don't make the same mistake I did, as the two long pieces that you connect on the inside of the Star Destroyer are, I accidentally had them flipped up around the other side, and I had to find out the hard way of switching them back over, which is completely my mistake of ignoring that part of the construction step of the model. But just a heads up, don't be an idiot like me. And of course, using liquid cement just to extra secure the model, just in case if any of the parts break off, as well as filling up any gaps or small seams. we can begin priming the model with this third generation acrylic AKA black primer, which is very nice for just applying and brush painting on your models, as I apply a few drops there into my palette, as also adding a couple drops of water to make sure it brushes on smoothly without any brush strokes. But do not worry if you do apply it on too thickly, just only be concerned about covering up the detail, as the acrylic polyurethane or whatever new formula they have mixed in with the black primer will help make the paint go smooth and level on the flat surface, as you will see here. But again, make sure it is nice and thin so you don't lose any of that nice detail. Now we'll be using a overbrush technique, which is very helpful with this Hataka gray paint, which you can just use almost any light gray paint in your paint arsenal. As using a frailed old brush, as you can see there, that springs back, I overbrush it on, or at least remove the excess on a paper towel, and then begin to overbrush it on the flat surface of the model, helping us give a good rough idea of where the highlights are and any other detail that we may have missed if we were to paint it just as with the light gray color that you see there. You can also use the other technique of dry brushing, as well as mixing in other colors like white to your liking. And of course, just pure white, as you can see here from Viejo, of just dry brushing those main little highlights, giving us a very helpful read on what the model may look like towards the end, with those deep shadows and those very light highlights. Now for the Death Star. A base color, I mixed together a Luftwaffe uniform World War II with just white, as to give us a nice bluish tint color, which I know the Death Star is in reality, or at least in the movies, it has a dull gray look with other dark gray panels on the outside, as well as the panel lines being lighter from what you can tell. But here, it's just my choice of trying to copy the box art that you may have noticed, that bluish hue that maybe have been reflecting from the sun bouncing off the surface of whatever planet it's closest to. But all in all, it's still my model, and I still want to have some fun with it, rather than it just being another dull gray color, which is very easy and simple to do. Of course, you can see all the panel lines, which will eventually be white, are nicely highlighted, but mainly this is a good settlement just for the unfinished parts of the interior that you can see inside the Death Star. But we are, of course, going to add some grays to it, as it's not just going to be a big blue Death Star station. We're still going to have other variations of grayish blues or just almost sometimes pure white, or a neutral looking gray that you will see me use later on. But again, with dry brushing, or even you can personally choose to hand paint the tiny little panels that you see there on the inside of the Death Star. But as a quick and easy way of just very gently and lightly applying on those highlights. And now for my, well, as far as you know, unless you're new, my well-known soap wash that I mix with water, the black paint that you saw there, which is very nicely thinned down, as if it's too thick, it would be too sharp of a color contrast on the panel lines, which is what we don't want. We want it to be in very nice soft tone. But the soap helps reach the paint into those deeper crevices and other small details on the model. Now we can paint those sort of orangish or rust color, not as rust, but if you've seen any of the movies that has the Death Star in view, you can see the Death Star 2 with unfinished little colors that I think look very nice for just applying onto other random areas. And it may not be completely accurate, which is okay. You can still have some fun with it with just using pure rust or mixing in equal parts of rust and ochre brown that you saw there. Now for the outer panel lines, I use neutral gray, Luftwaffe uniform World War II, and German gray as a nice variation of all those panels that you see on the Death Star, some lighter, some darker, or as in this case, some more bluish in tone. But again, it's up to you on how you want to paint your model. But of course, this will be lightened a little bit more with the whitewash that you will see me apply on later on. As, of course, I use the soap wash technique of mixing in the water, paint, and soap. But don't ask me how the soap works, because I don't know the science behind it of how or why I'm able to remove it. But at least in this case, we don't necessarily really have to remove it, as it's a very thin down and will reach its way into those panel lines on the Death Star panels. Of course, accentuating and making them pop out even more from just those dark panels that you would see. And I think I just realized I said panels 3 times. And I guess now you can say I said it 4 times. So, yeah. Now, let's see, we can use the light gray, sky gray, and neutral gray for our Star Destroyer, as well as using some white for those sort of accentuated other details. You can try to practice to paint on little squares, or you can, as I will show you later on, showing the another technique of overbrushing, of course, that you may have seen from earlier, but with the brush still moistened with water, which is alright since we can easily go back and darken the deep areas of panels and other details to help give them their nice deep dark color, as I showed you earlier. Of course, you can see now that I've painted on all the lighter squares, which will be now toned down with the neutral gray color, which will help blend in those any little awkward squares that pop out too much, like with pure white or just pure light gray, and it'll again nicely blend in together, or even help us create other fake panel lines and other just panels that would be on the Star Destroyer. As you will soon find out, it basically becomes a rinse and repeat, just trying to create highlights and other details, and then try to fix those mistakes, and then, of course, helping us with those accentuated details, like this black, the very thin down black soap wash, which, of course, we'll attempt to remove, which, again, may not come off entirely, since the surface is matte, and matte paint on, you know, matte paint tends to absorb with each other. If it were to be a satin surface, it would be a lot easier to work with as well as remove. But again, it still helps with blending, as we can also manually use a spray bottle to spray the surface of the model, or you can use your brush to moisten it, and as the surface is wet, you can continuously work with it as you let it dry, and also add on more dark washes, or maybe more neutral gray washes. As you can see here in the final stages of this video and the models, I'm just here very lightly dry brushing on pure white onto the very small little lights, or at least little bumps that you'd see on the Star Destroyer, at whatever detail it may be. And as we come to the end, I'd like to thank you all so much, as this is a very satisfying and fun time of just paint some more Star Wars models. And of course, this goes straight for my older brother, which I love and appreciate so much. So I will see you all next time.